Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv. For some of you, this is part two of the Mac Pro 6.1 trash can unboxing and plug it in, set it up video. What I'm doing in this part, well, let me just point the camera at the box. I'm going to be opening up and setting up a Dr. Obo, a Drobo 8D. But first, let me tell you a little bit about my love-hate relationship with Drobo. And I have quite a few Drobo units that are deployed. I had a significant problem with, I'm not sure what generation it was, maybe the second gen 4-bay Firewire device. I had two of them. Two 4-bays. And they worked pretty well for a while. Anyway, in their lifespan, some firmware updates and whatnot, and for whatever reason, both of them failed. Wow, I was pissed off, but not as pissed off as I could have been because I actually had them backed up on, don't laugh, I had them backed up on magnetic tape. Oh yeah, magnetic tape, the cartridges. It was an LTO4 cartridge. Be that as it may, what I was going to do for my core viewers, because you know people like seeing shit getting broken, I was actually going to toss both of them off my fourth floor balcony, dead serious. And I share that with my user base, and I also, you know, at Drobo on that one, just to let them know. And of course, the core viewer base is very excited to see me throw those things over the balcony. But Drobo did contact me and said, Alfred, we'd really rather not see those go over the balcony. And they took one back for analysis, never really confirmed much, but they sent me I believe it was a 5D, and then I stepped up and bought, at the time, the highest end Mac Mini, which was that 4-core i7, and ran it via Thunderbolt, and it's been working fine, though I might have some videos where I got pissed off at that one a little bit. But anyway, love-hate relationship with Drobo. I have a Drobo Mini that's being deployed, a 5S that's being deployed, and I have the 5D, which is all working. And now, the 8D, go big or go home, right? That was an Amazon Prime deal. The 8D is getting hooked up to this. Yeah, that's right. I'm probably the last person on YouTube, the last YouTuber, to buy a Mac Pro 6.1 trash can. And it doesn't really work very well as a trash can. Yeah. Yeah, damn it. Almost. Shit. Damn, it's not gonna happen. You get the joke. Okay, anyway, let me take this thing out of the box. Yeah, they do a nice job packaging this stuff. And, well, there it is. Well, there it is, out of the box. And I'll tell you, it's a nice heavy hunk of hardware, and let's pull a John Rettinger. Shout out to you, John. Okay, let's compare it to the size of my iPhone 10. Okay, so a little bit of a size comparison. I don't know where the hell I'm gonna put this freaking thing. And I'll tell you one thing, if this thing fails and I wind up throwing it off the freaking balcony, that thing will probably kill someone. Okay, look, I know there's a whole community of you guys that are like into this whole like peel the label off fetish or whatever. All right, so here we go. I'm gonna try to do this as gently as I can. God. All right, the condom is off. I mean, geez. I mean, look at this setup. The amount of money I've spent to make crappy YouTube videos for you all, it's completely ridiculous, redonkulous, whatever. Let's go plug this thing in. Okay, so what's in the box? The quick start card. Yeah, whatever. Power cord, we definitely need that. Oh yeah, the Drobo sticker. Yeah, let me put this on my Corvette. What else? Is that it? Maybe some cables? What else we got? And a Thunderbolt, whatever, cable. But this is USB-C, so I hope to God I can find that Apple converter cable, because that piece of shit is, you know, is Thunderbolt 2, that's Thunderbolt 3, and the Drobo site says you need the Apple converter because it's bidirectional. It's bisexual. It's bidirectional. Wow, I was pretty lucky. I found this relatively easily. An Apple Thunderbolt 3, aka USB-C, so it's Thunderbolt over USB-C to Thunderbolt 2 adapter, and if I recall correctly from what they've mentioned on the Drobo site, you know, this thing is bi-directional, and this is the one that's needed for technically that outdated, old, overpriced, non-expandable piece of crap that I just bought. Okay, that's pretty much the quick start. Go to Drobo.com/start. Yeah. I hope you all are digging the mouse pad. I mean, look at that. A Microsoft Windows 95 mouse pad. I mean, this thing is like priceless. It might go up on eBay for thousands. No.
Millions.
Okay, for the people into the peeling fetish, I'm doing this with one hand. This thing's like a sticky mess. Whatever.
Okay, I just got a message from one of the viewers. He asked if I got the Mac Pro 6 one. I replied yes. He said, oh boy, gotta watch it on the big screen with the popcorn, and he expects a shout out. Well, sorry, Nick, you're getting the shout out in part two with the Drobo, and here's a shout out. Okay, that's all you're gonna get. What else did you expect? And no, you're not getting the vet either. It's not for sale yet.
Okay, so I'm on the website drobo.com/start, and I thought I was just gonna go to a download page for the Drobo software. But it's actually prompting me if I want to migrate drives from specific models, and I'm not doing that. But that's actually pretty cool that they put that in. So make sure you go to drobo.com/start to get started. I'm saying no. All right, so yeah, insert drives. Okay, here we go.
Okay, we're taking a rear look first, and I just peeled off this sticker that was covering up this hole, and that area is for a solid state drive, an SSD, and that's for caching and whatnot. And I did just snap in, this plastic was like kind of sticking out, and I just gently pushed it back in and it kind of snapped into place. I'm not sure if this is supposed to be removable so you can clean the fans. Maybe it is. Either that or it's just a, you know, hey, first run. Hopefully it doesn't make noise. If this thing like rattles, I'm really gonna have a shit fit. But let's get the SSD, the SSD in there first. So I did speak with tech support and they recommended two brand SSDs. One of them was Samsung Blue, everybody knows one. Yeah, whatever, the musical quaalude. As a note, anything over 1 terabyte is like totally useless. This is just like used as for caching. It's not really meant to store files. It's just part of the internal operation. So even 1 terabyte was pushing it, but for the extra bucks, it didn't make sense to get the 512. But anything over 1 terabyte is useless as a cache, as per tech support. So this is going to go into the back. It's amazing how these things have dropped in price. And actually now we're going to have access to some useful information. If I'm reading these instructions correctly, the smaller connector is at the top, and that's actually the data. I put the extra R in there, the data connector, and the lower is the power. So that is the proper orientation. Either that, let's see, let's hopefully just like kind of, should just kind of, and okay, kind of wobbles going in, but I guess that's it. I mean, yeah, they could have made this a little bit tighter because it kind of, all right, it's in. I'm not gonna make a big deal. It's never gonna come out, so who cares? In, nice.
Agnib, I mean, bingo. Damn dyslexia. I found storage. Well, Drobo also had recommendations for hard drives. You really should check their website and look at the recommended drives. I believe, well, I don't remember what the hell I bought. This is, again, Amazon Prime shoplifting. Let's just open it up and see what's inside. Okay, recommended drives by Drobo Tech Support were the Seagate Barracuda, and I got them in a size of 8 terabytes. I have 4 of them. Rhymes with door, floor, whore, whatever. And listen, I know I'm taking a performance hit. This is a Thunderbolt 3 device that's basically getting stepped down to work with the trash can, which is Thunderbolt 2. And also, based on what I've read, I believe that if all 8 bays aren't filled with drives, you also take a little bit of a performance hit there. But hey, you know, this thing, I plan on using it for a long time, and you know, obviously I'll get a Thunderbolt 3 machine when the new Mac Pro comes down in price. I think it's what, $45,000 fully configured? Whatever.
Okay, so the Drobo has been reoriented, and like every other Drobo, this should be like a magnetic plate in the front, so I'm going to gently yank this, and yeah, just like all the other Drobo. So there we go, and basically we pop the drives in, no big deal. Okay, to be semi-useful, because most of my videos are not useful at all, I mean, there's the top of the drive, the label, the pins are in the back, and I pushed down on the gray tab. I obviously, I'm not doing it now because I'm holding the camera. Of course, I could get a tripod, but no. And then, yeah, just shove it. Yeah, you know, I got to push this down, all right, because it needs this to be relieved. But yeah, push it down, shove it in. Nice. Well, the drives are in a little bit of a problem. Like, I checked, you know, I ejected the drives, I pushed them back in. Oh yeah, this one, not ejecting. I mean, neither is that one. That could be a problem when you gotta change the drives. Like, what the hell? A little bit of, I'm gonna check this again. That does not make sense. Yeah, I'm a little pissed off. The ejection mechanism, not working too good, in my opinion. You're supposed to be able to easily get these drives out of the bay if there's a problem, so you can put in a replacement drive. And they're not coming out too easy. I mean, I'm going to check and see if there's... Yeah, I mean, that's what should happen. I mean, listen, the unit's brand new. I guess it has to be worked in a bit, but these are supposed to, like, pop out real easily. I don't... this is no bueno, in my opinion.
Okay, I have a fix. Yes, I swapped glasses. These are my reading glasses. I'm freaking old. I have a fix, though. Oh my God. Useful information on an Alfred.TV video. Let me show you what I did. You take Gorilla Industrial duct tape, the same stuff I used to wrap Christmas presents for the 92-year-old family member with arthritic hands.
Oh, what a bastard I am. Nancy's like 80 freaking years old. She's been around since they invented, like, fire. Look at what I did. I put, like, quadruple layer of tape so she'll have trouble opening the freaking box. That will add more to, like, the suspense when she opens this freaking thing.
Oh, Alfred, how did you tape this? I can't even open it. My hands hurt.
What, did I mess up with your arthritis?
Yeah, they hurt and I can't even look. I can't even do this. Look, they...
Well, I did use industrial tape, Nancy.
Oh, that's what you used?
And yes.
Alfred, what's the
purposely
deal with...
on me.
Yeah, well, it's so in good fun.
Alfred, what's the deal with this? Zip ties. I mean, really, this is what I use for the computer wires. This is for computer wires. So we're together. Not for gift wrapping.
No, it is. That's friggin' Cat 5 network cable. That's going to be tough to open, too.
Yes.
It helps. It's a good exercise.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And just like, you know, stick it on the drive and then give like a yank while you're holding down the gray thing. That will get the drives out. Because let me tell you something. They're not ejaculating. Whatever. I mean, no bueno on that, but the duct tape, give it a yank, and there you go. Done. Problem solved. So continuing on the website, and by the way, there is a manual for the 8D online. I downloaded the PDF. Okay, so insert drives. You're not getting any screen flow here. Don't expect it. So drives are running. I'm going to hit next. Connect Drobo, connect it to your computer with Thunderbolt, blah, blah. All right, so we're going to cable this thing up. All right, I'm going to actually shut down the Mac. I know you can hot swap this stuff, but I'm shutting down the computer.
Actually, I lied. This stuff is all hot swappable, whatever. I'm keeping the computer on. And, of course, like an idiot, I'm trying to use the USB-C cable into the adapter. That doesn't work. So I just opened up Apple's Thunderbolt cable. Look at the freaking length. Useless. I think I bought a few more Thunderbolt cables via Amazon. Hopefully it's in that box right there.
I thought this was like Thunderbolt cables. No, it's razors. That's not going to really... that's not going to work.
Okay, for this temporary setup, this
short cable worked, and I did find a 6-foot cable, though I might order a 9-foot cable. But again, to document the reason, another reason why the Mac Pro trash can was a failure. I mean, look at the mess of wires already back here, and there's nothing really hooked up yet. Anyway, oh yeah, definitely need power for the Dr. Oboe, Drobo.
Okay, so we're connected to the computer. Let's hit next. And attach the power cable, turn on the Drobo using the power switch located in the back. Drobo will take 7 minutes to complete, blah, blah, blah. The Drobo will flash blue, blah, 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 blah.
Okay, bottom line, gonna power up this sucker. Hopefully that rear panel doesn't rattle. Let's do that again. Contact. Yeah, probably have to plug it into the power strip. Okay, let's try this again. Contact. Okay. It's booting. It's gonna go do its thing. And then at this point, I'm gonna download the Drobo dashboard. And let's see if it comes to life. We should be getting, I guess it's going to do its automatic configuration and set itself up. I assume it sees the solid state drive. And so there we go. It looks like it's like powering off and then on again. Wow, could this be right? No way. Come on. Boy, I don't know. It looks like it's like powering up and then failing. That can't be right. Oh, wow. All right, you know, I'm still filming this. That really doesn't make any sense. All right, I'm gonna stop the camera. I don't know. Well, it's going a little bit longer. Maybe that's part of the diagnostics. It tries to see if the drive fails. All right, stable now. All right, no editing. This is, I'm just gonna let this run real time. Shit, man. That would scare the crap out of me, seeing that what the fuck? All right, the blue lights are dancing. All right, that's a good sign. All right, I think we're in good shape now. Green power light, bottom right, you know, stable. I mean, I don't know if that, I have to look obviously back at the footage, but I even think that went out. Okay, like again, I assume it's doing its configuration. So now I am going to stop the camera and let it do its thing. It's 11:43. I'll try to make a reference to the time when all the lights are up. In the interim, I'm going to go install the Dr. Oboe software.
All right, the Drobo software is in. It's going to require a restart, of course, on the Mac. You know, the security box gives an alert. You know, you got to unlock the machine with your password to allow it to install. I guess it sees that there's a virus or whatever. And let's reboot. And we're now at time marker 11:46 p.m. and the blue lights are blinking, green lights are kind of there, and it's still configuring itself. Okay, so the Mac rebooted, and the first thing that popped up is a diagnostic prompt. The disk you inserted is not readable by this computer. And if I remember correctly, you're not supposed to initialize it here. I think you work from the dashboard first, all right? But we'll discover and verify that as we move forward.
Well, I mean, look at this. I mean, even the green light in the bottom right goes out. I guess, again, this is all part of its setup, but I assume that this is normal, but, you know, hopefully this video is going to help some people, because, shit, this looks like a power failure. I would figure they would have at least, like, the green light in the bottom right persistent. I mean, the whole thing just goes blackout. Either that or there's a massive problem with this device. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. It's now 11:51. Still doing its thing. Well, I was trying to register the product, but it says no Drobo detected. It's still doing its dancing light gig. All right, and the Drobo dashboard says, you know, looking for connected Drobos, and I'm 99.999% sure you're absolutely not supposed to initialize it here. So I am going to hit, I think, ignore at this point, and wait for the Drobo to show up in the dashboard and then take control from there. Well, 11:55 p.m. At this point, I'm going to let it sit and rot. Unfortunately, I'm not going to know the timestamp when it comes online, but I guess there's going to be some more footage tomorrow. Either I'm going to break this into another part or just keep rolling with it. But I think actually there is some useful content seeing me do this setup, you know, with just the problems and everything else. So hang in there. There'll be more footage tomorrow. Well, I was trying to get to bed, but here we are, 11:58 p.m., and this looks like normal. Four green lights, the green ready light here, but the dashboard is saying still looking for connected Drobos. I'm just going to reboot the Mac Pro, and let's see if it finds it. Yeah, I couldn't get the camera on the screen quick enough. I got like a kernel panic error. Boy, I hope like we're not starting this crap right out of the box. That Drobo dashboard is like a virus. Java piece of junk. All right, let's see if we get this thing up. Okay, so after a reboot attempt and then a kernel panic, the Drobo 8D is indeed showing up in the Drobo dashboard. So let me go in there and, I guess, format it. So I asked for the status of the Drobo, and it says, hey, it needs to be formatted. So we're going to format it, configure this volume with Mac support, HFS Plus. It does not support APFS, but yes. HFS, hierarchical filing system, which is a gazillion years old. And we're going to come up with a cool name for the volume. Let me think about that. Okay, I'm calling this thing Synapse. And it's defaulting to a volume size of 128 terabytes. Okay, sounds good. Yeah, we'll buy more hard drives. Next. HFS Plus. Gee, where's the option, though, to... I want dual disk redundancy. I'm going to hit cancel. I want to do that. All right, actually, it sees the 4.8 terabyte drives. Good. It sees the solid state drive. I see a green indicator there. Blah, 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 blah. Let me go to tools. All right, it wants me to format them. All right, just go through it again. Next. It's called Synapse. Spell it right. All right, we don't have to have the camera running for this. I'm going to format it. Okay, now I have my freaking watch interrupting my flow because it wants you to breathe. Well, what do you think I've been doing for the past 24 hours? Yeah, I breathe. Okay, the format, it said it can take up to 5 minutes, but it's already done. It took under a minute. Drobo has successfully formatted your volume. You can now begin to use it for storing files. All right, let me see where that dual redundancy option is because I do want to arm that. Dual redundancy allows two drives to fail. And I listen, coming from experience, and Drobo even says this in their documentation, they highly recommend dual drive redundancy, and they also recommend backing the thing up. So I have to figure out a way where, as I load this thing up, I'm going to have some type of storage to back it up as well. Because, you know, the Drobo device protects you from the mechanical failure of the drive, but you can also have logical failure where something burps. And listen, I've been through it. Okay, I've been through it. So let me find the dual disk redundancy and almost done. Relatively pain-free. Okay, so now that it's been formatted, you go into Drobo settings and it gives you an option there for dual disk redundancy, which I'm definitely going to do. What's the trade-off? You lose some of the working storage, but the benefit is if by the rare instance, and I have had this, where two drives in the RAID array, or whatever you want to call it, fail, your data is still data. Your data is still safe. So highly recommended. Dual disk redundancy and figure out some external box so you can back this thing up. Okay, it's prompting me with a warning with regard to the dual disk redundancy, and it's going to reduce the capacity, because I don't know what it was before, but it's going to reduce it down to 14.5 terabytes. Plenty. Wow, it's a nice feature of the dashboard. There's a whole event monitor, so it shows how
each of the drives were added, and the uptime, and blah, 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 free space, 21, and it just says, you know, whatever, data protection started, dual disk redundancy enabled, blah, blah, blah. So far, so good.
And since I just armed that dual disk redundancy, those four green lights that were green, ready to rock and roll, they're now blinking between green and I guess it's kind of like an orange color.
And looking at the dashboard, you know, it says, you know, it's giving a warning on the health status because it's doing stuff. It's doing its data protection give. Oh, and this is going to take about an hour for it to reconfigure its Beyond RAID format, its proprietary internal gig, to go to dual redundancy, dual disk redundancy.
At this point, I'm going to let it sit and rot. I'm going to bed. I guess there'll be some more footage sometime tomorrow. Nice.
Oh, it looks so much cooler with the colored hue lights kicked in.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.